Diagnosis of DVT, deep venous thrombosis. There are three recommendations to diagnose DVT. Number 1, direct clot visualization with ultrasound. Number 2, non-compressibility with ultrasound. Number 3, augmentation with color Doppler. Number 1, direct clot visualization with ultrasound. Depending on the age of a clot, we may see an echogenic mass inside the vessel if our probe is directly over the mass. We may not be able to see acute thrombi because they are anechoic or hypoechoic and they tend to be near the edges of the lumen. As the thrombus ages, it becomes more echogenic and retracts from the vein walls, making it much easier to detect with ultrasound. So, when scanning for clots, don't just rely on direct visualization and always be sure to perform the compression technique to not miss any acute DVTs. Non-compressibility with ultrasound. We can also detect a DVT by compressing the veins. If we apply pressure with the probe until the artery compresses slightly and the vein compresses completely, there is likely no DVT at this region. But if we apply enough pressure that the artery compresses but the vein doesn't compress completely, this is considered a non-compressible vein, and it is likely the patient has a clot in that region. Number 3, augmentation with color Doppler. We can augment venous flow by squeezing the leg distal to where we are scanning. If color Doppler demonstrates homogeneous increase in venous flow, this suggests that there is no occlusive thrombus between where we are squeezing and scanning. If there is no increase in venous flow, there could be a DVT. Note, using this method with caution, as there could be a risk of dislodging in existing clots and causing pulmonary embolism.